Well, it's about time that we had a munch on our lunch.
Yeah, that's true.
Let's get munching on that luncheon.
So, oh, look.
Do you see what I did there?
Yeah, great.
It was great, wasn't it?
We've got double sauce. So, mustard and potato to lunch, lunch. Lunch,
lunch, lunch, lunch, lunch. And I'm very excited about it.
Plastic fork.
Thanks so much. Sorry?
Sorry.
Can I help?
Huh?
Can I help? You suddenly paused and looked expectant.
Yeah.
Oh, there is a lot of sauce there.
That's fine if you like a lot of sauce.
You can leave it out again and throw it away next Monday.
Or you could just use it all up straight away.
Oh, let's have extra sauce.
Yeah, exactly. Do you want extra chilli sauce or do you want some green stuff?
Extra chilli sauce.
Yeah, you won't like that.
I wouldn't touch that green stuff with it. Oh, God, you're going to mix sauces.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
See, now that is offensive.
Why? All right, we'll carry on about. I'll tell you what. Here's a question for you.
Oh, good.
Will you admit to something that you find offensive, but also you think is ridiculous, and you've kind of beat yourself up over it because you know you're being pathetic?
I could have, until you added to beat myself up over it. I wouldn't do that.
All right, will you allow me to beat you up over it?
I would enjoy the fact that I was being really petty over something that was relatively inconsequential.
That's typical, I suppose. She gets that.
I'm quite excited today. I'm quite excited that we've got to the bottom of the toilet of terror.
Oh.
I'm quite excited that we've discovered we've got some pans and stuff. I'm quite excited about the gas cartridges. Because they have a double use. Not only are they, can they be used in our... So we go halves on this one, yeah?
I've got the green one.
Oh. Yeah, but...
You have the lot of your
own. Oh, it's going to be too much, isn't it?
No. I made curry the other day, and my first thought before I started eating it was, I've gone over the top of this.
Which element of the curry did you go over the top with?
Well, I made a curry, and then I took some of that curry aside. Awesome. I took some of the curry aside.
Right.
And added about 20 green chilies to it.
Nice.
And then about a half a packet of spice mix for like one portion.
Okay.
Started to eat it. And
dear noodly Lord, thank you for blessing us with the gift of springtime. Thank you for blessing us with the gift of Mr. George Rajabhati. Thank you for blessing us with this lovely food and the nice knife and fork with which to eat it. Ramen.
And it was just right. It wasn't too hot after all. You underestimate my chili consumption...
capability.
Yeah, well, it's not really what I was thinking of, but yeah. Do you ever find, if you have a curry, and it was a challenging one, later on, you want another one. Nothing else will do.
You become addicted to that level of spice, don't you?
Mm. You really shouldn't wait till get this hungry before eating.
So,
yeah.
Of course, you had your Project Nigel meet yesterday, didn't you?
Well, yeah, you know that.
Yeah, but they mind that.
Of course they do.
So, so I guess the question is, did you enjoy the cynically put together excuse to try and get people to come and give you things?
Yeah. The problem is, it's a self-fueling thing, isn't it? If people give me things, I feel obliged to tell them that I've had it given to me, because it's rude not to do.
And then
but
other
by
people
doing that, oh, yeah, well, yeah, yeah. And when you come here, you have to give this man things, which isn't really the case. Not really. You never bring me anything.
That's so unfair.
Is it? What have you brought for me? Besides your company.
Beer. Momos.
Beer.
Kebabs.
One beer you brought me, which you admitted wasn't even any good. And then again, you don't like beer, so...
I bought you a load of beer the other week.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Courtesy of underscore.
Yeah, but I could have kept that. So technically it counts.
When was the last time you drank beer? And what was it?
Oh God. I honestly can't remember.
Well, that's quite exciting.
I'm not used to drink a lot of beer.
Yeah. And then you became sophisticated, did you?
Me and Rob, if me, Rob and Mel during a show, we'd normally do 40 to 50 bottles of Budweiser.
Right, so what about beer? When was you drinking that?
I can't remember when I transitioned. They say that your taste buds change as you get older, and there was just a point where I realised that beer tasted like shit and wine was amazing.
What beer?
Budweiser's
not any good.
And that used to be my drink of choice. If you go way back...
It's not when you went off it.
If you go way back, then... Springfield Bitter. Banks's Bitter.
Right.
Then that went on to... Tennant's Extra.
Tenants Extra.
Yeah. Used to drink that in the social club.
Oh, that's tramp juice, that, isn't it?
Is it?
Yeah. Oh no, that's Tenants Super, isn't it?
Oh, that's the. Yeah, well, I did go on to that.
Yeah.
Although Tenants Super wasn't my choice. That was too sugary. Kestrel used to be my favourite. And then there was it Crest? Kestrel was nice.
Was it?
You know, of all of the, like...
Did you like Skull?
10%-y ones. Oh, Skull Super, yeah.
Oh, they did one as well.
Obviously, I went through the Diamond White Phase. No, I didn't. White Lightning. White Lightning, £1.99 for a bottle.
That's hideous stuff.
Yeah, I know, but got the girls in the mood.
The kind of girls that would drink white, not White Lightning, and then jump into bed with a creepy bloke like you.
You've never spent Saturday night in a little Welsh mining village, have you?
No, I haven't.
No, that's how it goes. If you've got a bottle of White Lightning, you won't be on your own behind the bus shelter at 1 o'clock.
No. You'd be dribbling, escaping your made-up second personality.
It's a shame they didn't give us extra salad, as well as extra sauce. Might try and blag one next time.
Might as well. I thought he was going to do a blag when we was in there then, actually.
We should set each other a challenge. We should give each other an item and we have to use our alleged celebrity in order to get it for free.
Would you like to do that?
Yeah, it should be a weekly challenge.
Well, as it's your idea, it should be to me to set you a challenge first.
Should it?
Yeah.
Okay, go on.
Well, not yet. I need to spend all night thinking about something really appropriate.
Oh, that'll work well for my video. Thanks for that.
Well, I'm not interested.
What's your favourite video of mine that I've ever done? Little game. He's only watched two.
The one that you showed me before.
I genuinely like that one. Deserve more views.
How many has it got?
About 100.
Oh, I was going to give you 101. But my phone's in the car. Do you not want this?
No, you can have it.
The chips are soaking. They may as well be spicy.
What's the best video you've ever seen on YouTube?
I've answered that, so it'll take too long to explain it. Do you know what's the best video you've ever seen on YouTube? Was it that one you posted yesterday?
Yeah. I watched a video last night in the bath. That lovely Chinese lady, and she's got a Fender in China, I think.
In China.
And she went camping on her own, and she had one of those roof box tents like Matt's got.
Yeah.
Would you like one of those?
If I had a Freelander, I don't think it'd work on Eric, would it?
Don't know. You could put it on Nigel. He's got roof bars.
I wouldn't trust them. They're not made for use. They're a purely cosmetic thing, aren't they?
Well, on Nigel, yeah. What about on a streetwise?
No, same thing.
Really? Who do you reckon owned that bikini?
Well, you're the only one who's touched it so far, so I think it's probably you.
There seems like a lot of string.
To wrap around a fat back.
Oh.
In case you don't know, Boaty found a bikini. And he wasn't disgusted by it a great deal. He held it with both hands, flung it around and attempted to fling it at me.
Why would you be offended by a bikini?
Well, I wasn't offended by it.
I like bikinis.
Yeah.
Well, they hold breasts. And I do love a breast.
Is that too spicy for you?
No.
You're sweating.
I am, yeah. It's warm in here.
You love a breast.
I do.
I love two.
Do you work on both at once or take it in turns?
Work on?
Yeah. You know, when you're working your way through. Because unless things...
What, like set menu?
Well, it's the rules, isn't it? It's always, you know, a gentleman does boobs first. That always used to be the law.
What's the first orifice you get into?
The first orifice I get into? What do you mean?
You go with a lady?
Yeah. Oh, mouth.
Mouth?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Not the nostrils?
No. No, I've never interfered with a lady's nostrils.
Well... That was quite tasty.
Were you taught sex education at school?
Probably. Still hungry though.
Which school teams were you on?
School teams?
Yeah.
I wasn't a team player. Well, yes, I enjoyed that. That was with 2.5 tubs of sauce. I think that's what I need to ask for next time. Because the chips have gone soggy anyway. They're okay when you get them on the plate there. And they're crunchy. You put sauce on them, it ruins them. But if they've gone soggy, you can't ruin them, can you not? Did you just fart?
No.
How many young ladies did you chase while you were still at school?
Well, I went down the Debbie Hegg route, obviously.
The Debbie Hegg?
Yeah.
Is that her actual name?
Yeah.
Right. And why is it obvious?
Because she was the starter girl.
Yeah, you mentioned... Is that her real name?
Yes.
So you're going to use her real name on a public YouTube video?
Oh, sorry. Obviously, I went down the Dobby Hegg route.
Yeah. Real name, Debbie Hegg.
Everybody started with her.
Right, yeah, she was... Oh, gosh. Isn't that awful? Imagine she might be one of your followers, secret follower, and now she's going to be upset.
Why would she be upset?
You just said that everybody had a go on her.
No, they didn't have a go. No. These were innocent times.
Were they?
Yeah. I mean, in my day, then you're talking about the church disco on the last Friday of every month.
Yeah.
And a slow dance and a snog. And that was it. We're not talking about actual podgering. And yeah. Debbie was your Dibby. Dobby was like your starter for 10.
Right, well, so for no you. Converting. For you, but you.
I went out. I'm quite proud of this. You know how there's a most attractive boy and girl in the school? Every school had one. There's like the best looking girl. And in our school, the best looking girl was Leslie Bishop.
Is that a real name?
Yes, sorry. The best looking girl was Leslie Bishop.
Right, okay.
And
sometimes known as Leslie Bishop.
Yeah. She went out with the best looking boy in the school, because those were the rules.
Right.
And his name was Dylan Edwards.
Darren Edwards.
Yeah. Right. And we went on a 5-day, I've forgotten what you called it. A 5-day thing in the Malvern Hills. Excuse me. And Leslie Bishop fell out with Dylan Edwards. They had an argument. And to make him jealous, Leslie Bishop went out with me.
Right.
And we did the whole ridge walk. Like a 20-odd mile walk where you walk the length of the Malverns and back, up and down over all the tops. And we did it all holding hands.
Well, yeah, I mean, it must be just to make him jealous, because holding someone's hand whilst doing that would actually be a bit of an inconvenience, wouldn't it?
It was a lot, yeah, but I felt amazing.
Did you?
Yeah, I was going out with Leslie Bishop. Bishop. Yeah, brilliant.
Is that all?
And then that night, they got over their argument, and that was that.
Right.
So then, on the next school trip, which was to St. Fagan's, I did it, the trip, not it. With Donna Smith.
Donna Smith?
Yeah.
They're the generic names, these, aren't they?
Who was this ravishing redhead, and we sat together on the minibus and held hands as we walked around St. Fagan's, and she went on to become quite famous.
Did she?
Yeah.
Donna Smith.
Yeah.
The red-headed Donna Smith.
Yeah.
What's she famous for?
Marrying Freddie Starr.
It's an unusual way of getting famous, isn't it?
She was the
hamster.
She was the young woman that left her husband and kids to get with Freddie Starr.
So it was about money?
Who? Well, I don't know. That's not for me to say, is it?
Dunno.
She was working at a Pine Furniture cane.
You're going to eat some tinfoil there, by the looks of it.
She was working at a cane furniture place just down the road from my old showrooms that I've shown you.
Yeah.
Before it was a cane furniture place, it was a nice cafe. But now it's not. Some of the people watching will know this place. And might well know Donna. And Freddie Starr lived in a big posh mansion place near Studley. And he went in there to buy some stuff. And next thing you know, she's left her husbands and kids, and she's with Freddie Starr, and they got married, and they did Celebrity Wife Swap, that TV programme.
Would you like one of these?
You know what it looks like.
It looks like a canoe.
Yeah, that's right.
Cunnilingus biscuits.
And I think that was it. I think that was it for... Yeah, that looks outrageously wrong. But that doesn't surprise me because it's French. Now, I'll tell you a true story. And again, some of you will have experienced this.
Wait, made up ones.
This is not a made up story. When I was married, I took my wife, my kids, and my mother in a London taxi to France. Sorry?
Oh, the one that you bought?
Well, I had two, yeah. I had a Metro cab and an FX4. And we took Maurice the Metro cab and we went to Paris for a few days.
Yep.
And on the last day, I took them to Parc Asterix, which is, you know, an Alton Towers type mahoosive theme park. Massive. But it's Asterix themed. You remember Asterix from there? Right. So, and my favourite roller coaster is there, Tonnerre de Zeus. This amazing, huge roller coaster. But when we were when we weren't doing the big thrill ride and we were just looking around, there was, you know, a merry-go-round.
Yeah.
And there'll be like horses and coaches and stuff that you see. Well, this was an Asterix-themed merry-go-round. And you know on any merry-go-round, there's one where like three or four people can sit together.
Yeah.
Well, on this merry-go-round, which is obviously designed for young children, right? The one where three or four people could sit together was Obelisk. Do you remember Obelisk? The big fat guy from the Asterix cartoons?
No.
Right, Obelisk was a big fat guy.
Was he?
Yeah, with big stripy trousers that used to come up to there.
Does sound familiar.
Right. Now, he's bending over, holding open his own arse cheeks, and then the children walk through his rectum to sit inside his bottom on this merry-go-round. And that, some of you will have seen that. That is 100% true. That's the French for you.
I like the French.
I like the French. You're never more than 3 feet from an ashtray. And they understand about words.
There was Sonic the Hedgehog inspired by Asterix.
I don't know. I doubt it.
I like these.
Good. I'm glad.
I am a bit tempted to go and get my buses out of the fridge as well now.
You greedy person.
Just hungry.
You can't be hungry. You can't be really physically hungry. I mean, you've just eaten a full-size meal.
Yeah, but I was hungry. Than normal.
Have a look at the destructions and let's see if we can figure out how to sort this water.
Have we got? That's why I don't like cushions. You basically, they're there for you to move around so you can... do something else.
Do you have cushions on your bed at home?
I don't.
Are there cushions on your bed at
Pillows.
Home? No, cushions.
No. Optimus International. That looks a bit like...
British Leyland 1970s.
No, I was going to say, actually, it looks...
That looks like something you get in the handbook pack for an Allegro.
It does. Well, actually, that does more than that. No,
no, I think that does more.
It might. It looks like a takeaway menu.
No, it doesn't.
Right.
That's the cooker and oven destructions. That's the fan unit throat hairdryer. Registration card.
They've even cooker got oven. The carry-on typeface, type font there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like...
I love the Carry On films.
Yeah. Me too.
They were great.
Barbecue.
Oh, yeah.
How to operate Optimus Hub unit. Gas water heater for caravans. Well, that's the one that we looked at last week.
That's that one there to the left. Although this is kind of relevant now because we're talking about water, aren't we?
Self-venting submersible and inline booster pumps. Sometimes paperwork's just a bit too much of it.
Oh, you can set the temperature. Yeah. Ah, submersible booster
floor
pump.
Floor template.
Right, this has got to be something, hasn't it? Booster pump, that's got to be for... Oh, Christ. Oh, that looks scary.
See?
Yeah. The whale submersible pump is designed to be run fully submerged in water. It's designed to be run in the pipeline between the water supply and the outlet. So we must have one of these somewhere. Can you entertain them while I nip out for half a cigarette?
Well, just wait till we finish.
Well, because that would mean waiting until we're finished.
Well, we could just finish now.
We haven't done an hour yet.
Listen, why do we need to do an hour?
We've only done 31 minutes and most of it was crap. We haven't done the good bit yet.
Let's do the good bit. Let's just get rid of that bit and just do the good bit then.
Well, without them seeing it.
Yeah.
I suppose we wouldn't have to actually do it then. We'd just say we'd done the good bit.
That's true enough. In actual fact, that's all you really need anyway, is just to say that we've done a good bit. If you can be bothered, watch it. And you know that they won't do. So there's no point in us thinking of a good bit from not to watch. So just leave the camera on and we'll wander off and do something else for a bit.
Okay, that works for me.
That's what you was going to do anyway.
Great. God, it's so nice having this sunshine out here.
I don't know. Where else would it be? If you like paperwork, buy a caravan. Ah! Oh. This is what we're looking for.
Ah! Oh, now then.
Yeah, let's put that on the have a read through pile.
Well, no, let's actually read it.
You read it.
Lift flap and slide back out of sight. Remove pump and carefully pull out hose, ensuring that it is fully extended and not kinky. Place pump in water container and ensure that it is fully submerged. Oh, you were right then. You literally just put it in.
Yeah.
To change the filter cartridge, simply unscrew by hand and replace with a fresh cartridge. Replace at the start of each season. Okay, so it's drinking water because it's got a filtration system in it.
Yeah.
The life of the pump will be extended if care is taken to avoid it running in a dry condition. Do not allow the pump to freeze. Blah, 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 blah. Okay.
Oh.
So.
Wiring diagram.
Right, so let's assume that it's already installed, so we don't need to worry about lining the hole.
Fridge destructions.
Or fitting the unit. Oh! Fridge, we need that. Oh, it doesn't tell you how to use it.
All right. Well, maybe the assumption is that...
It just tells you how to fit it.
Yeah, but when you fit it, it's basically then you rely on a different set of instructions to know what you're doing after that.
Or maybe it's just self-evident.
Maybe.
So basically, this thing here, that... So the water is fed to the storage tank, that will heat it, that will then supply the hot water, and the cold water should just be a constant, so we need to fill the thing up. How do you turn the pump on?
I don't know. We'll find out.
All right, so we're a step closer, aren't we? Let's have a look at the fridge.
Caravan battery charging and distribution system. Instructions for use. Oh, that's that thing up there.
Yeah, I read that, I think.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, how does this work then?
Warning, in the event of an argument, sleep in the car. Let me pass, sir. Madam, as far as I'm concerned, the lunch video's over with because we've had our lunch.
No!